It's no secret. The Twin Cities is a hub for corporate headquarters. Best Buy, Target, 3M, you name it.
They're not a hub for corporate headquarters because of lots of tax breaks, or because of no regulation, or because of all sorts of abatements and giveaways. They're a hub because this is a great business environment. They're a hub because the state does the right things in order to make for great infrastructure, great public education, starting with a great university at which I'm part.
And Wednesday, Minnesota submitted its proposal for a second Amazon headquarters, H2Q. The state hasn't released details of the bid, but what if we win?
Headquarters, cities are, that's beneficial overall. So it's bragging rights?
Bragging rights are cool, but let's look at the setback Seattle experienced. The AP reports housing prices have soared faster than anywhere else in America, driving some low and middle income residents beyond city limits.
The housing prices are so high in Seattle, and the rental rates are so high for Seattle, particularly for young people, they're having a hard time breaking into that market. So while we have competition for lower valued houses here, right, that's where all the money is, it's still easier to buy a house here than it is in Seattle.
Amazon has helped transform Seattle. The company estimates its spending fueled the economy by $38 billion from 2010 to 2016. This latest project could bring a $5 billion investment and 50,000 jobs wherever it lands.
One of the strengths of Minnesota is that we have a variety of companies in a diverse set of industries, and that's what we want.
Governor Mark Dayton says Minnesota's proposal focuses on promoting the state's workforce, strong schools, and transportation network without PR gimmicks. So what if we do win? Could we see setbacks?
One of the problems with all of those companies is they tend to have a lot of contract employees. So people work for year after year and they're contract employees. They don't have benefits. They don't have any sort of job stability at all. So one of the things that you really want is for people to have those kinds of benefits and those that kind of stability, not year from year to year.
And we all know we have a significant representation of Fortune 500 companies. Our competitors are bidding aggressively. One economist at the U compared it to a beauty contest. But Jana and Rena, I can tell you everyone that I talked to said they do not think Minnesota will win. They blame the cold weather.
Really?
Really?
Yeah, I was just as taken aback as you guys were.
You and me, Coke. but I don't know that we've been giving. I mean, we haven't been promising the farm and all that to Amazon. We're like, you can come if you want.
Well, I think it's because Minnesota's trying to sell Minnesota on the fact that it's Minnesota. We have, you know, it's a good quality of life here. We do have so many other Fortune 500 companies. So I think it's kind of like, you know, like they're playing hard to get a little bit, you know, like, you know, you want us, we're it, you know, we don't need to offer you anything.
Right. If you come, you come. If not, it's all good.
We're
and we're not
too.
Handing out any freebies. We've got the work-life balance going on here.
There you go. Boom. I think we're going to get it.
Boom.
Okay,
you think we
she
are?
Said it here first on Breaking the News.
Oh, let's take some bets.
At 6:47.
Which city's going to get it? Oh, yeah. That means before we go to break, we're going to see what you had to say about the possibilities of HQ2Q Amazon 2's coming here. Check it out.